Thank you very much for your patience. We would now like to start the final program of this year's annual meeting, closing session. Throughout the 2 days of our annual meeting, we had 3 plenary sessions and as many as 19 concurrent sessions. The summary of those active discussions and the insightful presentations will be available on our official website within a few days. So please check our website for updates. The first program of the closing session is the announcement of ICEF Top 10 Innovation. Thank you very much for your votes, and we are excited to reveal this year's top 10. The presenter is Professor Georg Eldman, professor at Berlin University of Technology and a member of ICEF Steering Committee, and also serves as a member of the Top 10 Working Group.
Thank you very much. The Top 10 Innovation Project has, to my view, 2 aims. One is, of course, to promote innovations in favor of climate protection. And the second one is to create awareness about the broadness, about how much activities and how broad are the activities going around in the world in favor of these kind of innovations. The process this year has changed a little bit compared to the last year. We have decided to categorize the innovations into 5 different categories, 4 for different status of technologies, and the 5th is policy and standardization. Maybe one is a little bit interesting. The challenges, these are technologies which may become very important and which are very, very strange, but which are not in the pilot startup and the commercialization phase. Criteria, of course, large greenhouse gas emission reduction potential, excellence in innovativeness and feasibility. The selection process was very broad this time. The secretariat of ICEF collected 150 cases from the literature, scientific journals, and also some proposal from innovators. And then there was a second step. There was a working group. I had been the honor to be part of this working group, and we tried to reduce these 150 cases to 25 cases. And then it was you. You got a list of these 25 cases, and you selected among these 25 cases the top 10. Now, the winner is. No, the winners are. We have 10 winners, and these are the 10 winners. Of course, it is not the time to go through all of these technologies. I will mention only some of them. In the category of R&D, the innovation with the most votes was a French-German partnership which achieved 46% PV conversion efficiency in the lab. And the beauty of this project is that the result was confirmed by other research institutes, so you can be sure that this is really a serious result. Of course, we have to wait until this result is in the market, but still that is a research and development phase. The pilot and startup project, which got most of the votes in this category, was a wave energy farm in Australia. And the beauty of this farm is with the system is completely underwater, so you don't see the system from the shore. And it pumps water upwards, so you can run a turbine in a conventional type of turbine with this system. I think an interesting approach, which is actually in the pilot phase, and the investor is trying to develop larger and more projects of this kind. In the category of commoditization, there is a well-known project here in Japan, I suppose, the first commercial fuel cell electrical vehicle. And of course, this is a step ahead in developing new driving technologies. We are researching at least 10, 20 years on this technology, and it is a big step if now customers can buy this technology. Then challenging, it is really a challenging project. The researchers at the Michigan State University developed a transparent solar window, which filters only the invisible part of the light so that the window is still as clear as usual windows. Of course, the fuel efficiency of this, or the transformation efficiency is not very high, but of course the potential of application is huge. And finally, the policy and standardization category is Europeans' project to create a so-called single electricity market. Why this single electricity market is interesting for sustainable technologies? It can be that in some country in Europe there is an excess production of renewable energy, whereas in another country there is not so much renewable energy, or maybe there is a storage facility which could take the excess electricity from that country. So with a single market, it is easy to translate this kind of electricity across Europe, and of course Europe is a large area, so this is an interesting project to promote sustainable technologies. So I gave you a small overview about the result, and I hope that next year you will again be here, and you are the key to vote the final winners of the top 10 ICEF innovation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Erdman. The next program is a presentation of ICEF Roadmap. Now I'd like to introduce the presenter, Mr. David Sandalo, inaugural fellow of Center on Global Energy Policy at Columbia University and a member of ICEF Steering Committee and chair of ICEF Innovation Roadmap.
Thank you very much. The first ICEF Innovation Roadmap was discussed this afternoon in a lively discussion. I'm going to very briefly report on the ICEF Innovation Roadmap project, our progress to date, and our plans ahead. The goal of this project is to use the ICEF platform to help promote the development and deployment of clean energy technologies. In 2015, we've had some following activities. We've consulted with members of the steering committee, consulted with other experts, done a literature review on roadmaps, built a core team, had discussions with potential partners, including the WBCSD, the World Business Council on Sustainable Development, the International Institute for Applied Systems Analysis in Vienna, the International Renewable Energy Agency, the Bloomberg New Energy Finance, and decided after the foregoing to develop this year a solar and storage roadmap. Let me tell you a bit about the solar and storage roadmap, which was discussed in our lively concurrent session this afternoon. A draft was submitted, and the goals are to assess possible scenarios for deployment of solar and storage technologies, to identify strategies for overcoming barriers to deployment of solar and storage technologies, and then more broadly, to evaluate potential methodologies for ICEF innovation roadmaps. The scope of this particular roadmap is to look at solar and storage in combination, at solar at rooftop and community scale. We're not looking at utility scale solar in this roadmap. Here's a timeline. This project is being done on a very accelerated timeline this year. Really, the first discussions of this began in May. In June, we had discussions with a number of potential partners. In July, we engaged Bloomberg New Energy Finance to assist with the roadmap. In August, began initial data compilation, held workshops. In September, prepared a draft, which was presented this afternoon. We will, tomorrow, begin revisions. In November, finalize a text for release at COP21. I'm going to just take you through the content of this quite quickly. This was discussed in great detail this afternoon. Some of you were there. But for those of you who weren't, just to give you a sense of the type of content that's in this roadmap. And here are the seven sections. The first is on technology background. And Bloomberg New Energy Finance, which has got just tremendous data and expertise in this area, has pulled together data on a lot of things, including, as this chart shows, demand and supply for PV modules with the very sharp increase over the course of the past decade, the PV experience curve, which will be familiar to many of you, and this is, the top is crystalline silicon, and the bottom is thin film. Similar data for EV lithium-ion batteries. In the top left-hand corner there, you see observed costs or reported costs, and then projections. The bottom blue is BNEF's interpretation of Tesla's costs from their press releases. We've also collected a lot of data on the market and natures of the market. This is breakdown just of production of lithium-ion battery by country, but some very interesting material we've collected on specific companies and patterns there. We're going to survey R&D programs. We're in the course of doing that, and in particular to try to discern, to the extent that they're being publicly reported or they're obtainable, the technology targets in the different public R&D programs that are out there, and here are just some of them that are listed. We're also interested in corporate programs. I think we expect data on those will be more difficult to obtain. We have a lot of information on countries. We've identified five countries that we're going to do case studies on, or we are doing case studies on. United States, United States, Germany, Japan, India, and China. And for each of those, collecting a lot of data to understand the market. This is the generation mix in each of those countries currently and projected out to 2040. I know I'm going through this quickly, but there's a lot more detail if anybody is interested in participating in this process. Looking at regulatory structures in each of these countries as well. And here's a chart that shows the regulatory structures in Japan, which are going through some changes. But those regulatory structures are obviously hugely important to the development of these technologies. We're doing an analysis on the sources of uncertainty using a matrix methodology in which we have low impact to high impact on one axis and low uncertainty to high uncertainty on another axis. Among the initial conclusions, interestingly, cost of storage is high impact and high uncertainty. Cost of PV technologies is determined to be low impact with medium uncertainty, low impact because the cost is already low enough that it doesn't have a big impact on these systems, and it's a better handle on the direction of the cost there. And then regulation, very high impact on this path to the technology and high uncertainty as well. And then having gone through a number of factors and done analysis so that we've populated this matrix in this way and done that both for emerging markets and for developed markets and for emerging markets. Then doing a scenario analysis, looking at the movement from unattractive economics and defensive regulation to attractive economics and supportive regulation in different pathways, and different pathways through and how they might proceed in all of our different five countries. And it generates graphs like this, which are quite detailed, and which provide some insights into the possible directions that that this technology might move in the decades ahead. And then the point of that is to identify barriers and then strategies for overcoming them. Here are some tentative analyses that the potential barriers include. Regulations protecting utility incumbents, storage costs declining slowly, cheap alternatives, trade barriers putting upward pressure on PV and battery prices, market spoiling, and weak economies. And the lessons learned, that strategies vary significantly by country. Utility regulators are key. Cost curves matter a lot. R&D investment is essential. Trade barriers can slow deployment, and quality standards and technical training promote market growth. It's an exciting project, and then the next step will be to finalize this roadmap and then consider possibilities for the year ahead. We're going to discuss with potential partners their interest in working with ICEF, and then select topics and partners for the 26 roadmaps. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sandalow. Next, Dr. Yoichi Kaya, the chair of the ICEF Steering Committee, will present this year's ICEF statement by the Steering Committee. Dr. Kaya, if you please.
Thank you. I'm Yoichi Kaya, the chair of the Steering Committee of this meeting. So, I think you have this statement from the Steering Committee just in front of you. This statement, however, is not a reflection of the discussions of this meeting because of time limitation. Rather, this statement is our comments on the future strategy for mitigating climate change. I don't think it's appropriate to read this document now because of time limitation. Rather, I'd like to show you just a few slides reflecting this kind of document. Next slide. This is just the introductory part, so I'd like to skip this one. And we have three recommendations in this statement, you know, connecting to the strategy for development and deployment innovative measures. The first one is just implementation. Recommendation one is just implementation of policies to promote R&D of innovative technologies. So here we stress the importance of the role of private sector, particularly together with the need of appropriate government policies that direct both public and private investment toward R&D of low-carbon technologies. here, we like to stress the importance of private sector role. Second one is not a actual recommendation, but the real act we did. As David now told you about the details of the roadmap project, we are now in a position to promote making roadmap of innovative technologies in future. This year, we made the roadmap for solar power and related electric storage. So we are now thinking of the next type of innovative technologies for the object of roadmap of next year. The third one is a promotion of financial scheme for technology transfer to developing countries. This is an appeal to international organizations such as World Bank, WECSD, and others to expand financing to technologies which contribute both emission reduction and economic development. Furthermore, we expect private sectors will do the same kind of activities. That's the outline of the statement. So I hope after finishing this meeting, you could read this two-page statement, you know, in detail. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Kaya. And next, I'd like to ask Mr. Yoshihiro Seki, Parliamentary Vice Minister of Economy, Trade and Industry to give us a comment. Mr. Seki, if you please.
ただいまご紹介を賜りました。
Thank you very much for the kind introduction. I am Yoshihiro Seki, Parliamentary Vice Minister of Economy, Trade and Industry. I am very grateful and thank you for coming all the way to Tokyo to attend the second annual meeting of ICEF, or Innovation for Cool Earth Forum, and for taking part in extensive discussions. We had more than 1,000 participants at the meeting this year, which exceeds the 800 that participated in the first meeting last year. This great success is certainly attributed to the contribution by Professor Kaya and all the other steering committee members, as well as all the speakers in all the sessions, and all of you who took part in this meeting. In this year's ICEF, we were inspired by the variety of discussions on the roadmap for solar energy, the cooperation among funding agencies of different countries, the efforts of different industries such as steel and cement, and technology transfer to developing countries. We're going to introduce these activities of ICEF as stepping stones to the specific actions that are emphasized in COP21 and contributing to its success. In addition to the sessions prepared by ICEF, IEA, or the International Energy Agency, and IRENA, or the International Renewable Energy Agency, reported their latest efforts in this meeting. I would like to further develop ICEF into a platform in which various interested parties could come together to disseminate information and stimulate lively discussions with global leaders among business, academia, and governments for tackling the climate change issues. The third annual meeting of ICEF will be held on October 5th to 6th next year. I'm really looking forward to seeing you again at that meeting, where you can bring back the outcomes of your progress between now and then. I would like to close my remarks by finally wishing you the best of luck and great success. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you. To conclude the program, Mr. Kazuo Furukawa, the chairman of the New Energy and Industrial Technology Development Organization, NEDO, will give us an address representing the host of ICEF.
Oh, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Kazuo Furukawa, chairman of NEDO, New Energy and Industrial Technology Development Organization. As co-host of this ICEF, I would like to say a few words. Please let me extend my heartfelt gratitude to all of you for participating in the second annual meeting of ICEF. More than 1,000 participants came together for 2 days' meeting. I would also like to express my sincere appreciation to the member of the steering committee led by Professor Kaya for their dedicated effort to organize this meeting. In recent years, the world has been frequently experiencing abnormal weather. For example, during this year, in May, smothering heat waves hit India. And in September, the worst downpours in 50 years caused severe disaster in Japan. Today, it is widely recognized that such extreme weather phenomena are mainly caused by global warming. There is no time to lose in addressing climate change issues. Therefore, expectations are increasing for innovation in energy and environmental fields. Since it is established in 1980, NEDO has been promoting technology development and demonstration activities with the aim of promoting innovation. NEDO organized ICEF together with METI to provide a global platform for promoting discussion and cooperation among distinguished researchers, business persons, and policy makers from around the world. We will endeavor to make the best use of the outcome of ICEF and strive to realize innovation for addressing climate change issue and producing a practical application by leveraging such innovation. New international framework on climate change for 2020 and beyond will be decided at COP21 in Paris. Given this, I must say it was very timely to have discussion at ICEF plenary session on the themes of principal issues for future GHG reduction and future strategy for climate change. A common awareness as well as the latest information was shared among the participants. At another plenary session with the theme of future perspective from innovators, visionaries, and global leaders, the discussion clarified that the outlook of global warming countermeasures is not at all gloomy, and we should consider addressing climate change issue as an opportunity to realize a better future. As Prime Minister Abe stated in his message, it is important to set specific objectives for achieving innovation and share such objectives among relevant parties by providing an easy-to-understand roadmap. For example, the development of individual technology will not be sufficient to realize low-carbon society. Establishing the necessary infrastructure, such as smart grid system, and reforming relevant regulations will also be needed. This will make a low-carbon society capable of maintaining a balance between energy supply and demand. In this respect, roadmap can be an effective tool to develop a common view and also produce a synergy effect among people involved in achieving innovation. Thus, discussions on various roadmaps were held in ICEF session. Roadmap for solar energy and electricity storage that was discussed today will be introduced to COP21 as one of the outcome of ICEF, as Professor Sandaro explained before. The number of concurrent sessions doubled from last year. The session theme included the technology transfer to developing country, where the amount of CO2 emission is still expecting to increase, as well as energy system, including coal-fired power generation. And we discussed many issues today too, especially in last plenary session, part three. Many issues were discussed, a little different from innovation, but it was very, very interesting for me and maybe for every participant. And we will therefore ensure the ICEF continue to provide global platform for discussion among researchers, business persons, and policy makers. Following COP21, these same will continue to be discussed for every opportunity. I would like to conclude my remarks by wishing you and your families good health, prosperity, and happiness. I look forward to seeing you again next year at the third meeting of ICEF in Tokyo. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Mr. Furukawa. And this concludes all the programs of the ICEF second annual meeting. We hope this year's annual meeting was a fruitful opportunity to network with each other and exchange expertise to tackle the issue of global warming through innovations. And I'd like to ask you once again to give us your feedback through the ICEF satisfaction survey. We appreciate your cooperation. ICEF will hold the next annual meeting in 2016 on October 5th and 6th here at Hotel Chinzanso, Tokyo. So hope to see you again next year. And this evening, there will be a farewell dinner on the first floor of this building. Please relax and enjoy the dinner. Once again, thank you very much for your participation and see you next year. Thank you.